start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York,
New York. Come beat your moment, dreams are made of. There's nothing you can't do. Count your New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. Big lights will inspire you. Let's hear it for New York, New York, New York.
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever.
Good evening. My name is Quentin Thompson, and I am the 2021 president of the Ben F. Jones chapter of the National Bar Association. And on behalf of the entire board, we want to welcome you to this year's Barristers Ball. Our theme for tonight is the 1920s Memphis Renaissance Revival. We are also celebrating the Memphis Arts Community. The 1920s are particularly important for this organization because three of our founding members were born in the 1920s, the Honorable H.G. Lockhart, S.A. Wilborn, and Dr. Benjamin Hooks. Those three individuals, along with James Estes and Benjamin F. Jones, make up the first five members of this organization. This organization was formed in 1966, so that means that tonight we are celebrating 55 years of our existence, 55 years of African-American attorneys, law students, and judges doing everything we can to create a more diverse and equal society for everyone. Some things you need to know is that our digital platform for tonight is Better Unite. Better Unite is where you will be able to go and look at sponsor information, see other important details about tonight. But the most important thing you need to know is that that's where you would do all of your bidding for the silent auction. So you'll see different paintings and various artwork displayed throughout the venue. So you can go and bid on that through Better Unite. And you also see just a plethora of different items that we've had donated from many different companies and organizations. So we hope that you will bid, and bid again, because the proceeds from this event all go towards scholarship awards, as well as different endeavors that the Ben F. Jones chapter has to fulfill, such as the National Bar Association Convention, which will be held here in Memphis, Tennessee next year. In just a couple of moments, the host will come up and she will be sure to recognize all of the judges and elected officials. But I want to just congratulate our scholarship recipients, Tiearny Parson, Ferris Elkhayyat, and Alexxas Johnson. I also want to recognize our honorees, Professor Demetria Frank, who was just named not too long ago the Associate Dean for the University of Memphis, Cecil C. Humphreys School of Law. She's the Associate Dean for Diversity and Inclusion. I also want to recognize Senator Raumesh Akbari, who is one of our AA Latting Award recipients this evening. And I want to recognize a guy that we all know and love, Chancellor Will Perry, who is the other AA Latting Award recipient this evening. In the 1920s, there was a phrase that was often said or posted outside of some of the speakeasies, and it stated, good vibes only. So tonight is all about good vibes only. I know that the last couple of years have been trying on everyone, and we haven't been able to do this event in person in 2 years. And although we had a successful virtual event last year, there's nothing like being here in person. I'm seeing all the people that we look forward to seeing every year at this event. So I want to thank the Vice President and President-elect Laquita Stokes for chairing the Barristers Ball Committee this year and doing such a phenomenal job. I want to thank the board for all of their hard work this year. I want to thank our chapter, and I want to thank all of you here tonight that continue to show up for the Ben F. Jones chapter of the National Bar Association. So I hope you brought your 1920s gear. I hope you plan on dancing to Jay Chisholm and the M-Town Band and listening to the tunes of DJ Anonymous. So come on out in your flapper dresses and your fedoras and your other 1920s get up and just have a great time tonight. So remember, good vibes only. And again, welcome to the Barristers Ball.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a welcome from the 79th president of the National Bar Association, Judge Carlos Moore.
To President Thompson, President-elect Stokes, members of the judiciary, distinguished guests, honorees, scholarship recipients, my lovely queen, to everyone under the sound of my voice, good evening. It's my distinct pleasure to bring you greetings on behalf of the 67,000 African-American lawyers, judges, law students, and law professors across America that I have the privilege of representing as the 79th president of the National Bar Association. We are so privileged to be with you here in Memphis as you celebrate 55 years of service to the city of Memphis, to the state of Tennessee, and the outstanding Ben F. Jones chapter, one of my favorite chapters of the National Bar Association. And we are elated and excited that Memphis will be hosting us for our 97th annual convention, July the 24th through the 29th. And based on what I see here tonight, we are going to have a time in the Bluff City. We are so excited. The last time the National Bar came to the city of Memphis was 1998. So after 24 years, and after 2 years of a pandemic and 3 years since we've last had an in-person convention, we will be ready to kick back and have good vibes only. And so again, on behalf of the 67,000 African-American lawyers and judges across this country, our 80 affiliates across the country and around the world, I congratulate all of you on this august occasion, and we're here for a good time. We'll be right back.
let's go, let's go.
Hello,
come on.
Good morning. Hello, good morning. Know you've been waiting. Too far.
Hey, yeah. It'll turn me up a little bit more. I don't think they can hear me. Check this out. Let's work. Let's work. Come on. Let's work. Let's work. Don't stop. Let's rock. Let's work. Let's work. Make you feel good to the next one. Don't stop. I see you. Let's work. It's that dirty money.
Hello.
To the Barristers Ball. It is so good to see each and every one of you. As Quentin said earlier, and also the president of the NBA, good vibes only tonight. You all look fabulous. The theme this year is Roaring Twenties, the only decade with a nickname. A lot of us know it from The Great Gatsby. One of my favorite movies is from this era, Harlem Nights. Yes, we know it as the decade of flappers and bootleggers because it was also the time of Prohibition. The 1920s are also called the Roaring Twenties because that's when we first started having cars, radios, telephones, and technology. The Roaring Twenties. Look around you, everyone, and see how far we've come. In this building, this beautiful decor, I also want to thank the T.L. Williams Dance Academy. Those young people are amazing. At this time, I would like to recognize our dignitaries. You please feel free to stand, wave, just do what you feel tonight, because it's good vibes only. First, we have Police Chief Sarilyn C.J. Davis. National NBA President Carlos Moore. Former Mayor A.C. Wharton. Dean Catherine Shafton. Judge Valerie Smith, Judicial Commissioner Demita Dandridge, Judge Patrick Dandridge, Judge Mark Ward, Judge Gina Higgins, Judge Betty Moore, Judge Chris Kraft, Judge Carrie Woods, Chancellor Joday Jenkins, Judge Bernice Donald, Judge Deborah Henderson, Judge Lois Lambert Ryan, Judge Jerry Stokes, Justice Janice Holder, Justice Holly Kirby, Judicial Commissioner Taylor Batchelor, Judicial Commissioner Shayla Parafoy, Judge Danielle Sims, Judge Jennifer Mitchell, Judge Dan Michael, Magistrate James Franklin. Let's keep celebrating, people, because we are amongst many dignitaries. Let's keep celebrating them. We have Magistrate James Franklin, Judge Yolanda Kite, Chancellor William Perry, retired Judge Ernestine Dorse, Judge Louis Montesi, Judge Mary Wagner, And we also want to say congratulations to Judge Denise Barnett, the new bankruptcy judge. And I also wanted to make the Judge Yolanda Kite and Judge Rynette Hurd, who are not present here, donated their seats to worthy law students. Hi, we have Judge Gomes over here, probate court judge. We are amongst dignitaries, many dignitaries, as you can see, whom we all should celebrate. But looking out on this crowd today, you all are a wonderful crowd, and we all should be celebrated tonight. So please give yourselves a round of applause.
Again, we will say that we are honored to be here in the presence of so many dignitaries and lovely people, but we want to honor God for just a minute this morning also, this afternoon. May we humbly bow as we pray before to our God. Father, today we joyfully approach your throne with hearts filled with gratitude and hands overflowing with praise. Father, our spirit is filled today with hope and love. We come today before you being thankful today just for the simple pleasure of being able to assemble. We thank you for the cherished moments we have today that we lost for almost 2 years. Thank you for your protection, God. Protection in the midst of a time filled with crime, filled with violence. But yet, God, you have brought us this for today. But Father, as we pray today, we want to take a special moment. There's one that is normally among us who is not here today. We assemble as a broken circle today, trying to celebrate, and at the same time, God, we're mourning the loss. We need to pray today for the family of attorney Sean Hunt, one you called home just this week, one God who's loved, one God who's always supported this event, has always been one who gave back to this city, and Father, one who is greatly missed on today. Lord, we pray for his wife, his family. We pray that they find comfort in thy word. They find peace in your presence. We pray that they find consolation, Father, in the precious memories that they should take with them here on earth. Father, we thank you for the blessing of being a part of this blessed assembly tonight. Father, knowing today that we're not here because of the good that we've done. We're not here, God, because of how great we are. But God, we're here because of the great God whom we serve. God, we approach your throne today, giving thanks for all those pioneers that made this event possible today. Those that work hard, faithfully, and fearless, God, even among so many hardships and difficulties. Yet, God, they designed and organized an organization designed to promote, Father, today and support the lovely thing we have today, God. We thank you for the vision of men committing their lives, men such as already been mentioned, such as the first five, men that other folks followed behind, men that made so many commitments. And God, we thank you for the zeal of those young people today who pick up that torch and continue to fight that fight, continue to invest in education, continue, God, to invest in professional development. Continue, God, to promote education and flawless execution of business standards. Father, today as we rejoice, we celebrate the work, God, the accomplishments of the Ben F. Jones chapter of the National Bar Association. We pray that they never lose focus of the job that lies ahead. We pray that they never lose focus of the opportunities that must be taken advantage of. Challenges that remain to be conquered. Injustices, God, that still need to be made right. Today, God, we thank you for those committed to carry on, God, those who are protectors of dream, defenders, God, of hope, those who never lose sight of the vision, those that committed to seeing justice prevail. God, those who envision a day when we can truly say, we can truly stand up and say that we are one nation under God. indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Father, we pray that you bless this assembly. Bless each speaker today that you grace this podium. Bless each one that's going to be honored tonight. Everyone that sponsored, everyone that made this event possible today. God bless all those who are similar here with the same goal, God, trying to make a difference. And God, even more, not just making a difference, but trying to be the difference that we want to see. God, may we always acknowledge you as God. May we always honor you as King. May we always worship you as Lord and serve you, God, with our very last breath. It is in your name we pray, God, tonight. It is your name we give thanks. And may we say to Jesus, amen.
Yes, sir.
They told me I was supposed to give thanks for the food also. I'm sorry. Now we're going to preach your microphone. Let's pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the blessing of this food. We thank you for those that have prepared, those that made everything possible. We thank you for this food that we're going to be about to receive for the nourishment of our bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
You did it anyway.
He is a true preacher.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do want to let you know, you see that beautiful salad that's in front of you? I do want to let you know that you can start eating that beautiful salad if you haven't already started. We're going to get ready to serve dinner.
Are you Dr. Bay still cool? I just thought of eating here. Dr. Bay still cool. Yeah, she was in a rush, gave
me the two old pages. That's what I was referring to. She gave me this.
You gonna use his mic?
Two. Mic check 1, 2. Come.
Ooh, yeah.
Listen.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be shin till the evening come, yeah. Watching the ships rolling, and I watch them roll away, yeah, yeah. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away, baby, yeah.
sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time, yeah. Oh, baby, listen. I left my home in Georgia, and I'm headed to the Frisco Bay, yeah. I have nothing else to live for, and I guess nothing's gonna come my way, yeah. Sailing on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away, baby. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time, yeah. Listen to me, honey, now. Looks like nothing's gonna change. Seems like everything remains the same. I can do what 10 people tell me to do. Guess it remains the same. Sitting here resting my bones, and the loneliness won't leave me alone, yeah. 2,000 miles of road just to make this dock my home, baby. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away, baby, yeah. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time, yeah. Go on and take your time, yeah. Ba 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 ba. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time,
Ladies and gentlemen, I have two announcements to make. We do want to let you know that tonight's program can be accessed with the QR code that's on your table. Tonight's program can be accessed with the QR code that's on your table. And I am also looking for Miss Lexi Carter. Miss Lexi Carter, could you come to the stage? I have a very important gift to give to you, Miss Lexi Carter. The gift that I have for you, Miss Lexi Carter, is your very own Visa MasterCard that you left at the bar. But Lexi, before you get this card, you gotta let this gentleman know what the last four digits on the card is. That way we know it's you. Lexi? Miss Janika White, could you come to the stage, please, Miss Janika White? Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm back. You all may continue eating, but we are going to move on to the next part of our program. And first of all, before we move on, wasn't Jerome Chisholm and the M-Town band amazing? Yes, they are wonderful. We are now going to move on to our scholarship awards. And at this time, I'm going to call one of my friends from way back to junior high school and high school, who is now a distinguished attorney with Memphis Light, Gas, and Water, Mr. Jeffrey Lewis.
Good evening. My name is Jeff Lewis, and I'm the Scholarship Committee Chair. The very first thing I want to do is give my appreciation to the Scholarship Committee for their time and dedication during this project. Those members are Carlos Bibbs, Commissioner Shayla Purifor, Tamika Purnell, and Justin Bailey. Our scholarship, the Judge D. Army Bailey Scholarship, is evaluated on academics, community service, and perseverance through challenging circumstances. And I'm glad to say that we have three recipients that are well-deserving of the scholarships this year. So as I call your name, please come forward, and I'm gonna ask the audience to please join me in congratulating Tiearny Parson, Alexxas Johnson, and Faris Alhayat for being our 2021 NBA Judge D. Army Bailey Scholarship awardees.
Change ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations.
Johnson, can you come forward?
My mama called, seen you on TV, sunset. Done change ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations.
There's Alexxas Johnson. She stepped away for a second. You all, let's give her a round of applause as well. We will now have presentation of the AA Latting Award for Community Service.
coming. Just because the length of your hair ain't long, and they often criticize you for your skin tone. Wanna hold your head high, cause you a pretty woman. Get your runway stride on and keep it going. Girl, live your life.
I just wanna be myself.
Yeah,
don't
yeah.
Sweat, don't be yourself. Follow me, follow me, follow me. Girl, be yourself.
That's why I be myself.
Thank you so much to the Ben F. Jones chapter of the National Bar Association for giving me this amazing award. You know, as a state senator, we just do the work. Memphis has many needs, and we have many needs across the state of Tennessee, with the COVID-19 pandemic to education, criminal justice reform, and economic development. My plate is always full. But it has been an absolute pleasure to serve my community in this way. And I'm so thankful to President Quentin Thompson, Vice President Laquita Stokes. I'm thankful to my family who's here now, my parents, some of my great friends, my twin sister Ramina, who could not be here. Without you all, I would not be able to do the things that I do in this community. And I want to thank my district. You all elected me in 2018 to serve you all, and I hope that I've done it with dignity and I've brought pride to our community. But just know that the work continues. Like Dr. King said, we must all be drum majors for peace. We must serve in any way we can, whether we are a cook, a dishwasher, an attorney, or an NBA star. We must do our part to make the world a better place. Thank you so much for this honor and this award, and also special congratulations to my colleagues, Will Perry and Demetria Frank, who are also being recognized tonight. Thank you.
Celebrating the things that everyone told me would never happen, but God has put his hands on me. And ain't a man alive could ever take it from me. Working with what I got, I gotta keep on taking
it. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce the spoken word artist, my brother, King Dre. You ready, Dre? Let's go. Here we go.
Go, 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 and on the count of three.
Go, go,
go, go, go, go, and on the count of three.
Go,
go, go, go, go, go, go. On the count of three, everybody run back to your fantasy now.
Go,
go, go, go, go, and on the count of three.
Go,
go, go, go, go, and on the count of three.
Good evening. Has there ever been a time whereas we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created, but equality is relative, it's subject to the interpretation of men who only see other men as men who share the same skin as them? It's left a number of citizens questioning the very fabric of their existence, asking questions like, I am a man, or ain't I a woman too? Therefore, we need more truth seekers and truth tellers to tell it like it is, because truth be told, do we even know what the truth is anymore? Because it's not what is, it's what you can prove. Well, it's not what you can prove, but what you believe. And no matter how unsubstantiated your truth may be, if you're following substantial enough, whether you can make or believe anything. So I guess that means anything goes. One little girl with a cell phone changed the way the world saw things. Or did she? We watched a man scream to the heavens for his mother's protection until he was breathless. Yet some would argue that that was standard protocol, while others stand in awe of what we all saw. Yet some would say, I just didn't see it that way. When their truth was emphatically and mathematically inaccurate, some people would rather be led by their own convictions, even when they're rooted in fiction. These are some very dangerous times we're living in. When the courts of public opinion have more dominion over the outcome of court decisions than judges do. What do we do? How do we fix this? We need warriors with pens. Men and women who won't fret from justice for personal interests or corporate expenses or politics or the rich, but be rich and merit in attacking the status quo. Be it apropos for them to propagate truth when they mitigate and be unwilling to fold. Defenders of democracy, even if it means being civilly disobedient and defending my civil liberties, because life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness by contractual agreement are my birthright and your duty to uphold. So what's the holdup? Because I am a man, or ain't I a woman too? And some would say Black Lives Matter or Transgender Lives Matter too. Freedom of speech really ain't free. It can cost you if you say the wrong thing, and if it's my body, then it's my choice if I don't want the baby or the vaccine. Cancel culture is a cult. Maybe that's why Biden did cancel student loans. And the big lie changed the way we vote. Now Kanye running in 24. Listen, I'm indifferent about our differences in opinion. I just want, when you argue, to be led by truth. Be who we need you to be. Governed by a moral authority. And more importantly, govern yourselves accordingly. I'd now like to present Senator Raumesh Akbari. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome. It's an honor to represent FedEx Express as a supporter of the Ben F. Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association. On behalf of more than 500,000 FedEx employees around the world, let me congratulate this year's honorees and the student scholarship recipients. It is always exciting to recognize individuals who have accomplished so much in the field of law and jurisprudence. It is equally exciting to recognize those who are pursuing their dreams in this profession and to support them in that quest through their scholarship opportunities. I have the privilege of leading a very broad team of legal professionals at FedEx Express all across the Americas, from Canada to the tip of South America. The counsel that comes from a team of such diverse legal minds is part of the secret sauce that makes FedEx who we are. I learn something new from them literally every day. FedEx is a strong champion of diversity and inclusion in our businesses around the world. We are honored to be able to partner with the Ben F. Jones Chapter to foster even greater inclusion in this field to which we've all dedicated our lives. Let me say how thrilled I am that our home city of Memphis, Tennessee, will host the 2022 National Bar Association Convention. We are looking forward to working with you to showcase our city and help make that a memorable event next July. So again, on behalf of FedEx, congratulations to tonight's honorees and to your chapter for your excellent work in our community.
Let's give another round of applause to our recipients. Now, you all saw me earlier. I came out, I was dancing, and I thought I was on a roll. And it's come to my attention that I left off one of our very, very distinguished guests. And as they say in the old school Baptist church, please charge it to my head and not my heart. In this case, please charge it to me skipping some kind of way on this list. I apologize because Judge Felicia Corbin Johnson, if you would please stand, you are celebrated and you are honored by us. We appreciate your service and all that you do. We will now move on to our AA Latting Award for Legal Excellence. Thank you.
Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association for granting me the AA Latting Award for Legal Excellence. I come from a very rich tapestry of friends, family, mentors, and mentees of all stripes. But because the AA Latting Award recognizes legal excellence in the Black community, I want to highlight a few Black professionals, friends, family, and mentors who have made everything that I've ever done in law and in life possible. Obviously, I have to start with my parents, who were the first in their families to attend college, my mother, who was a career educator, and my father, who became an educator after he retired. He taught math and my mother taught English. I want to talk about the first lawyer I ever met, Professor Beth Hopkins at Wake Forest, who's a former U.S. attorney and who taught my first year legal writing class at Wake Forest. I want to talk about my law school friends who inspired me, Ashanti Davis, Trent Pointer, Janika White, and Brooke Hyman, and the one Black professor that I had in law school, Dwight Ahrens. Carla McCanders, who was also a professor there, who's now at Vanderbilt Law School, is a friend of mine. I want to talk about the law firm Butler Snow. I spent the last 10 years of my law practice and where I started right out of law school. In the Memphis office of Butler Snow when I started were Van Turner, Al Bright, Carlisle White, and Effie Cozart, all of whom have continued to advise and counsel me throughout my career. We used to call our little group Butler Black, but Butler Black is not limited to Memphis. Melvin Malone of Butler Snow's Nashville office, Charles Griffin, Laverne Edney, and Rod Richmond of Butler Snow Jackson, Don Bookhart of Butler Snow Denver, Trey Hairston, Ashley Wicks, and Keyshawna Randall, all of these lawyers, all of these Black lawyers, have played an incredible role in my life, have mentored me, counseled me. Once when I was thinking of leaving Butler Snow, Charles Griffin drove up from Jackson, Mississippi to tell me to stay. Melvin Malone reviewed even my application to the governor for the judgeship that I now hold. I talk with him every week. I'm so grateful for all of the friends and mentors that have been in my life. Ed Stanton and Keenan Carter arrived at Butler Snow a few years after I did, but I have had the honor of working with them and under them for the last 4 years. I can't thank them enough. I want to talk a little bit about the mentors that I've had in the Memphis legal community who were not at Butler Snow. In some ways, their willingness to pour into me is even more important because they didn't necessarily have anything to gain. They just adopted me into their own families and made me a part of their family, and now I have a whole additional set of brothers and sisters and surrogate parents. Foremost among this group is Bruce McMullen, whose advice is always colorful, but his loyalty and his wisdom are beyond match. He and his wife, Judge Camille McMullen, hosted a party for me when I made partner at a different law firm. I can always count on Bruce, and I very much appreciate it. Of course, I can't say anything about mentorship without talking about Judge Bernice Donald, who had the honor of clerking for after law school, who continues to advise me, and the judge crew that advises me now that I'm one of their number, Judge Hurd, Judge Higgins, Judge Henderson, Judge Corbin Johnson, Judge Kite, Judge Stokes, Chancellor Jenkins, Chancellor Kyle. I'm so grateful for all of these people in my life. Before I stop, I want to talk about the friends, like the siblings that I told you I have. And I have to start with my two sisters from another mother, Danera Gibson and Joanne Costin Holloway. I love you very much. Thank you. Amber Floyd, Asaki Baptist, Asia Diggs, Gabrielle Lewis. Thank you very much. Andre Mathis, David McKinney, Ahmad Abdullah, Michael Joyner, Damon Griffin. I wouldn't be here without any of you. And to the army of mentees I've had, my former students at Sherwood Middle School and at Memphis Law, the students that I've coached on mock trial teams, the other mentees that I have gathered over the years who make sure that I stay in line when I think I'm keeping them in line, thank you. Thank you all very much for this award. When you are surrounded by a community as strong as this one, a cocoon that says nurturing and positive and constant as mine is, it's very hard not to emerge a butterfly. Thank you.
me, I'm all the way up.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm welcome for Miss Bernice, or Judge Bernice Donald. Here we go.
Absolutely excellent. President Quentin Thompson told me I had 2 minutes, and I am a respecter of time. Dr. King said that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice. It doesn't bend of its own volition. It bends because men and women of goodwill, men and women of character, men and women of excellence push and pull the arc in the direction of justice. One of those men is Chancellor Will Perry. You know, it was probably inevitable that he would receive this award. Will, as you heard, was born to educators. Early in his life, he developed an ethic of excellence, a zest for education, a commitment to the betterment, not only of himself, but of others in his orbit. And so as a student, he demonstrated that excellence. He then went on in high school and college to demonstrate that same commitment and that same excellence. When he graduated, he himself became an educator. And then he went to law school, and I may have the order reversed, but he went to law school and he continued to be excellent in everything he did. He loves the law. He teaches the law. He imbues students with a love and thirst for knowledge of the law. As a judicial law clerk, Will worked long hours because he wanted to make certain that he got it right. And as a chancellor, he continues to study and work hard to make sure that he got it right. At Butler Snow, as you've heard, he was a lawyer who always prided himself in being well, an excellent arbiter, advocate, oralist. So for Will Perry, he is an individual who allows his light to brighten the path of every other individual with whom he comes in contact so that they may find their way to their highest and best self in the law. He is respected, he is admired, he is adored, and he is emulated, all because he is excellent in all that he does. And so it is my honor to have the opportunity to present to him the A.A. Latting Legal Award for Legal Excellence, one that he deserves so very much. Will, come forward. Pardon me, Chancellor, come forward. Is that his? Is that his microphone?
Yes,
I don't think I can improve on what I've said already. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, Judge Donald. Thank you, everybody. This is a wonderful event, and I'm so happy to be a part of it. Thank you very much.
When I think about the mission of the Ben F. Jones chapter of the National Bar Association and everything we have tried to accomplish for now over half a century, no one exemplifies our mission, our goals, our values, and our beliefs more than Professor Demetria Frank. She is someone, in my opinion, who is able to assess a situation, pinpoint the problems, and come up with new, creative, and innovative ways to remedy those problems. Just an example of that is the Memphis Professional Development Program, where she, in a way, has completely overhauled the mentorship program with the Black Law Students Association and the Ben F. Jones chapter. It used to be there would be one mentor, one mentee. You would pair those two together, and you would hope that it would be a successful pairing. But from her talking with members of BOLSA and doing research of her own, she found that there's a better way. So she decided to change that program, and now she has various levels of law students and various legal professionals on one team, and that increases the likelihood that you will have a successful pairing. She's also been innovative and creative by coming up with school to attorney pipeline programs, such as her high school program, where they have an opportunity to either do a policy track or a litigation track. She has a college program where she's targeting and exposing as many minority college students as possible to the legal profession. And she's just really the go-to resource for any underrepresented student at the University of Memphis. And she continues to be in their lives after they leave the law school. She has been a monumental resource for the Memphis Bar Association, for Ben F. Jones, and she has been on panels. She has done amazing research and has been published in some very impressive journals. She just has done her job and has fulfilled the role of what it means to be a director for diversity and inclusion. And it's no surprise to me that she was recently named the inaugural Associate Dean for that same title. One thing I've read in her bio is that she hopes to influence and inspire underrepresented students, but what I know is that she has emboldened their lives in ways that she will never know, and she had changed the trajectory of their lives for the better. So I just want to say congratulations to you, congratulations on your so well-deserved appointment, and it is with great privilege that I've named Demetria Frank, Dean Demetria Frank, the 2021 recipient of the Ben F. Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association President's Award. Congratulations.
Ancestor put me on game, long time on gold chains, with my ocean energy. Drip all on me. I'm good at a shiki friend. Hola, Donna, Stella, Sasha, Nacha, Bison. Yo, pure ice, 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 ice. Bust down, bloody, 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 bloody. Put my wrist out.
I'm extremely honored to be named as this year's President Award recipient. This award really means so much because it has been one of the best blessings of my life to serve the University of Memphis and broader Memphis community in ways that are aligned with Ben F. Jones' mission of enhancing Black attorney performance and professionalism. I sincerely thank the Ben F. Jones chapter for this recognition, but more importantly, I thank the chapter for guiding our students in tangible ways that allow us to maximize the potential of Black students as a community. Your support has been absolutely instrumental in Memphis Law's ability to create and sustain the pipeline programs we all wish were around when we had dreams of becoming an attorney. Because of those of you that continuously show up for our students, we have been able to sustain efforts like our Memphis Professional Development Program, providing law student networking opportunities that inspire the support system vital to attorney development. Through the efforts of our supporters, students, and faculty, we have been teaching policy and trial advocacy to high schoolers through our Summer Trial and Advocacy Institute. This past summer, we launched our virtual pre-law undergraduate scholars program, where undergraduate students from all over the country study criminal law through a critical race theory lens with the guidance of Memphis Law students. You heard that correct, a critical race theory lens, and the undergraduates appreciated that experience and were enriched by it. Thank you to the Memphis Law staff and faculty who helped sustain this important programming and who are committed to our students becoming purveyors of justice. Specific thanks go to our law school dean, Catherine Shafson, and our dean of admissions, Sue Ann McClellan, who appropriately prioritized diversity and justice-related efforts. We all know our students are awesome, but I must give specific thanks to our Diversity Office graduate assistants who we absolutely could not do this work without. Lupita Martinez, Trenton Woodley, Devaris Minor, and Takesha Johnson, thank you for your ideas, hard work, and energy. Thanks also go to Ms. Stephanie Hope, the Diversity Office Administrative Assistant, and to our Pipeline Fellow and recent graduate, Amber Campbell. Thank you also to the many former students who helped identify the need and build these programs. Thank you to Memphis Law alumni, Judge Bernice Donald, Judge Gina Higgins, Attorney Dawn Campbell, Brittany Williams-Davis, Patrick Hillard, Tanera Gibson, Ashley Finch, Amber Floyd, and Joe Smith, who have each supported and influenced our institution, students, and pipeline programming in so many important ways. And thank you to friends of the law school like fellow honoree Chancellor William Perry, Ben F. Jones past president Quentin Thompson, and past president Commissioner Shayla Purifoy, who have supported as if Memphis Law were their own law school home, and I hope you somehow feel like it is. It is truly a privilege to do what I do, and even more of a privilege to be amongst professionals who are continuously supportive of those efforts. Thank you again to President Thompson for this exciting honor. I look forward to continuing great work alongside the Ben F. Jones chapter.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome members of the Benjamin L. Hooks chapter of the National Black Law Students Association.
Can everybody hear me now? Okay, fabulous. Hi, my name is Alexxas Janae Johnson, and I am the current president of the Memphis Law Black Law Students Association. So thank you all so much for having us here and allowing us to speak to introduce the great Dean Demetria Frank. As the current president of the Cecil C. Humphreys Black Law Student Association, I'm happy elated, ecstatic to introduce Dean Demetria Frank as this year's 2021 President Award recipient. Can we please give it up for Dean Demetria Frank? I met Dean Frank briefly at the 2019 Diversity Day at the Cecil C. Humphreys School of Law, and at that point, I had not even applied to be a law student at that point. But from that moment forward, I knew that she was someone that I needed to know, not only because I needed to get into law school, but because it was evident, it was clear, it was unequivocal, the devotion, the support, and the meaning that diversity students at the Memphis Law School meant to her. So from that moment, I knew this was somebody that I needed to have in my corner. And little did I know the amount of gratitude that I would have towards this woman, as she has been an advocate, a trailblazer for not just me and not just all of my colleagues that you see behind me, but for those who have not even entered into 1 North Front Street in downtown Memphis yet. So for that reason and many others, we want to congratulate Dean Demetria Frank for her award. So thank you so much, Demetria Frank. We love you.
Good evening. My name is Matt Morgan, and on behalf of Morgan & Morgan, we want to congratulate all of tonight's honorees and scholarship recipients. We also want to congratulate, very importantly, Morgan & Morgan attorney and Ben F. Jones president Quentin Thompson and his entire board on a successful year. As the largest personal injury law firm in the nation, we know firsthand how important diversity and inclusion is in our profession, and we are thrilled to provide all of the resources Quentin needed to ensure that his presidency, the Barristers Ball, and the upcoming National Bar Association convention, which will be held in Memphis next year, are all a tremendous success. I hope you are all enjoying your evening and have a great time here tonight. And Quentin, again, thank you for everything that you do for Memphis. Thank you for everything that you do for our law firm. You've been a tremendous asset to the people and the constituencies that you represent and to our clients. So thank you for all that you do.
I want to remind everyone that this is a fundraiser. We want you to please make sure that you take advantage and go over there and bid on some of those wonderful pieces of art. We have donations from many, many vendors. I went back there and I'm really excited about those pieces. Please go back there and bid, bid, bid. They are going to extend the auction for 10 minutes. So instead of ending at 9 p.m., oh, 10 p.m., we'll be ending at 10 p.m. So you have time to bid. Please feel free to move around once the band starts playing and go back there and bid on some of those items. I want to go back just a little bit to the recipients and just say,
what just a wonderful, wonderful thing it is that we have such young people who are stepping up into service. Chancellor Will Perry, Senator Raumesh Akbari, and Dean Demetria Frank. And I also want to acknowledge one of the biggest trailblazers, Judge Bernice Donald, and congratulate her on taking senior status on the Court of Appeals Sixth Circuit. I also want to say that after I went back and I started looking up some other things that happened in 1920, I found that in the 1920s, the Roaring Twenties, by the end of the Roaring Twenties, there were 160,605 lawyers. Of those 160,605 lawyers, barristers, 1,247 of them were African American. And of that 1,247, only 24 were female. And in the year 1920, that is the year that women gained the right to vote. And as I take my seat, we've acknowledged so many of our distinguished guests, our judges. I want to say to the ladies here, from one of my favorite movies, The Color Purple, Shug Avery, sister, remember your name, oh, sister, gonna steal yourself away, my sister. We sure ain't got a whole lot of time. So shake your shimmy, sister. 'Cause you women barristers are looking fine. That concludes my time as you all's hostess for the evening. I want to say thank you, Ben F. Jones Chapter, for allowing me to serve in this capacity. It's been a great honor. It's been a pleasure. I have thoroughly enjoyed my time with you all. And I just want to say a huge, big, big thank you to the president, Quentin Thompson, Laquita Stokes, Taylor Batchelor. These people worked extremely hard to pull this together, and it looks amazing. And now I present to you our president, Mr. Quentin Thompson.
Good evening. Everybody enjoying those good vibes only? All right. So I will not take too much time. But first, let me just say thank you to our MC of this evening, Janika White. I want to again congratulate our scholarship recipients. Let's give a round of applause to them. I want to say congratulations to Tennessee State Senator Raumesh Akbari, Chancellor Will Perry. You all may know, but we're all here tonight because Chancellor Will Perry needs another award, so that's why we're here. Dean Demetria Frank, congratulations to her. I want to say thank you to the 2021 Ben F. Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association Board. If you all would please stand. And thank you all. Please stand around the room. Let's give them a round of applause. The running joke of this year, whenever anyone comes up to me, they always say, Quinn, you're in charge of everything. You know, and I have been in charge of quite a lot this year, but I will say that out of everything that I've had the privilege of leading in my lifetime, being the president of Ben F. Jones has been the greatest joy of my life. So thank you all for trusting me to do this. At the very beginning, I knew that this was a huge task to take on. I know that so many amazing, wonderful presidents came before me. So I was afraid at first, but I just focused and I just tried to do the best job that I could possibly do. And I hope you all are proud. This Barristers Ball, in my opinion, has been amazing. I want to say thank you to Vice President, President-elect, and Barristers Ball Chair Laquita Stokes. I want to say thank you to the rest of the Barristers Ball Committee. If you will all stand across the room, everybody needs to know who spent so much time putting this event together. And I just want to say thank you to all of my mentors, my friends, and colleagues in this legal industry, with a special thanks to someone I know that I can call on for advice no matter what, and has been an anchor for me throughout my leadership in this position as well as other positions, the Honorable Gina C. Higgins. Hey, Judge. So I just want to say that I have had the privilege of working with many, 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 many people, but I do not know someone that works as hard as our next president of the Ben F. Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association. I can't tell you the number of texts and emails that I have received at 6 a.m. and 3 a.m. and 2 a.m. Like, she pays attention to every little detail, and in my opinion, she's just the hardest working person in Shelby County. Nobody works harder than her. She's the person that I tell every person that approaches me about a divorce, I say, go call Laquita. And they all come back and say, thank you for giving me her information. She was the best attorney to help me through this difficult situation. No matter what, somehow she always found time to go to Bible study. I would call her on Wednesday night and she would say, hold on, Quinn, I'm in a Zoom Bible study. So somehow she managed to prioritize that, which is a great thing. And I'm sure that is what has kept her calm throughout organizing and dealing with the Barristers Ball. At the end of last year, when I was thinking of who I wanted my vice president to be, I knew that I had to go out and select Laquita. She has just put so much dedication and effort toward this chapter. She was already the 2022 National Bar Association Convention co-chair. She was someone that jumped on every committee. Anytime you need someone to do something, she was quick to raise her hand. So I knew she would be the very next right person to lead this organization. We have a big year next year. We have to navigate judicial elections and all the other elections. We have to host the National Bar Association Convention, but she is the one to do it. So, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome the 2022 president of the Ben F. Jones Chapter of the National Bar Association, my friend, my colleague, someone that I am truly blessed to have worked with in this past year. Let's give it up for Laquita Stokes.
Farewell, but I'm back. In the words of our Honorable Gina Higgins, I'm going to take a point of privilege here. As I was performing, I was looking directly at another one of our distinguished guests that I missed on our list, but that we celebrate, we honor, and that we cherish, and that is the Honorable Camille McMullen. Please stand. Thank you. Now, our beloved Laquita Stokes.
First of all, thank you all for coming tonight. It is seeing the vision come to life. I've only had 1 hour of sleep, so. but I'm so happy to see how everything has come together. First of all, let me just thank Quentin for his wonderful presidency, as well as our past president, Shayla Purifoy, whose idea it was to have a 1920s theme. So Quentin, we appreciate the leadership you've shown us this year. And we want to present you with a nice award as well. Dean Frank, I'll take care of that issue you have. I just want to say, I didn't know when Quentin and Shayla recruited me for this position that I'd be signing up for a national convention and an election year. They didn't tell me that, but it's so, they definitely left that out, but it's so, the committee that we have, the board that we have for next year, I know we're gonna work very hard. I'm so thankful for all the judges who came out tonight. I believe this is one of the biggest crowds or one of the biggest participation of judges we've had, according to Judge Higgins. So I appreciate all the judges, the judiciary, all of the dignitaries here tonight. I must thank, well, let me say this. My dad is long-winded, but now y'all know Judge Stokes is not my dad. You've met my dad tonight. But I want to thank my family and my friends who always support me, my business partner who are here tonight. I really appreciate their support. I must also thank this committee and all of the law students who helped us tonight. I apologize for anything that went wrong, but of course, this is the first big thing we've had. But I appreciate everyone being patient with us and working with us. I have to thank my mentor, Judge Corbin Johnson, who initially is the one who encouraged me to get involved with the Bar Association, as well as Attorney Linda Holmes. The last 2 years have flown by so much, but it's just so good to see everyone here tonight. We have a big year hosting the 97th annual convention, and Judge Doris has been my right hand as well as many of the committee members. So far, we have pledges and commitments totaling $151,150 of our $250,000 goal. So I'm going to be emailing you more. Tonight, we've raised almost, if not already, $70,000. So thank you all for participating. Remember, tonight is a fundraiser. This is what this is. So please participate in a silent auction that features many people. Jade Miller is doing a live painting if you have not gone over there. There are raffle tickets and everything. Please participate so that we can raise the funds that we need to run, well, to have this convention. I really don't have anything else to say because I'm so sleepy and I'm tired. But thank you to the band. Thank you to Applesauce Bartending. Thank you to the DJ. Thank you to Delectables Catering, Message in a Bottle. Everyone, and make sure you check out the digital program. But thank you all for coming. Stay, party with us, and enjoy your night. Thank you all.
Thank you.